Hello there, everyone. Welcome back to our new Mask of Truth. In between episodes, I did a few of those, all of them, really. Immunity ticket trials that just opened up. Some of them were very tricky indeed, and I am hugely grateful to YouTuber, I'm not even going to try to pronounce your name, if you want to look for videos on how to get through all that, YouTube provideth. I will say no more. We are now back from Kujyuri, and we just saw an interlude with Entua and Vurai, and although at least Vurai seems to think Entua is not our friend, Entua gave some pretty clear indications that she kind of doesn't want this to get any worse than it is. I mean, she just has the worst luck, doesn't she? Yeah. Well, thank you again for letting us choose. Off as it is. Didn't we discuss this before, though? Alright, that was using the lake on the other side of the mountains for water. That is not the same thing. Yeah, fair enough.
それって筒状で中身が空洞になっている植物。そう。
Okay, well, I can see why that would be a problem. Secret plan, you say? Okay, problem solved. Okay, well, that's not what I was expecting, but having a supply of water is always a good thing. Oh, that's nice of him. Famous last words. But yeah, Nekone kind of does need a break. Yeah, She's had it rough. And she's, of course, constantly reminded of her loss and the great big deception she's party to. Sisters, that is not the kind of thing she needs right now. Just leave it be. Yeah. And what are we gonna do about that? Not a whole lot we can do. So let's just save the game and carry on. While they're discussing this, by the way, I want to mention something. Well, more than slightly insane, I suppose, that I did recently. I bought... I've played Tears to Tiara 2 on the PlayStation 3. And I thought, kind of a nice game. And so I thought, hey, this is Tears to Tiara 2, wouldn't there be a Tears to Tiara 1 then? And indeed there is, except it was never translated. I have no idea what reason, I went on Japanese Amazon and found a, I'm not sure if it was new or just slightly used, but I have here a copy of Tears to Tiara 1. It is, pretty much a game like this. A lot of visual novel stuff going on and SRPG gameplay in between. And like I said, it was never localized. Never translated. Not even the menus. I have fuck all idea what's going on in that game. What I was going for there was that this developer has followed a rather unique trajectory in terms of visual fidelity. I mean, fair enough, the Utaharumono games were also released for the PS Vita. I don't know if the Tears to Tiara games ever were, but in terms of fidelity of the 3D stuff, Tears to Tiara 1 is actually top of the food chain there. The models are, dated, I suppose, but you can tell that they were going for fidelity there. Here in Utaharumono, they are of course a bit stylized and I wouldn't say simple, but I can tell they have tried to keep it low polygon. In Tears to Tiara 1, they did not. Tears to Tiara 2 is, I do believe, older than the first Utaharumono game. I would have to check that to be sure, but I think that's actually the case. Tears to Tiara 2 is one step down in fidelity from Tears to Tiara 1. The characters are more stylized, in the vein of Utaharumono, but they have shading of the 3D models. I think They used the Havoc engine for that, which they also used in Tears of Jara 1. They do not use that for shading in Utawara 1. So, from the original Tears to Tiara 1, released in, is it 2008? To this game released in 2016 or 17, they've actually scaled down their visual fidelity. It will be interesting to see what this new Utawara 1 game, I forget what it's called, Mobius something, how that will look in terms of fidelity. I think they will still have the general style of characters, but from what I remember of the trailer, they have improved the fidelity at least a little bit. No, Nekona just had a bad day with the scrolls. You're still tired, kitty. Have you been sleeping at all? Just asking for a friend. Liar.
I'm sorry.
So here's a crazy idea. Maybe we could just not have decided on this deception, Haku. At least then Nekone would have been able to open up to someone and just try to deal with her sorrow instead of having to keep up appearances. Just an idea. Well, let's go on for a few minutes. Actually, let's not. I think I will end it here, and we shall call the next episode Nekone's Bad Day. See you then. And how about we all collectively kick Aqua Plus on the shin for this? For Nekone's sake. Until then.